then Tarman will charge, and you see the size difference. And we'll just use archery to do that. And the dragon seems to be taking quite a lot of damage. I should be aiming at his legs to cause the cripple effect, which might increase our own damage against it by because of strength perk, and we were a little bit too close there. That spamming arrows is higher DPS than making those concentrated hits. And so far it looks like dealing damage faster than Tarman's taking. Now, what was the tool used to get as much dragon bone as possible? Start by using our pick. With one dragon horn. Bone, Demon Blood. What about the hatchet? Dragon Bone. Skinning Knife? No. So we only got one Dragon Horn from that Undead Dragon, which is unfortunate. Because big dragons are supposed to give you more than one. But maybe this one didn't count being the Undead one. It's usually easier just kill multiple small ones to get the Dragon Horn you need for the crafts than to kill a single big one. This is the gallery.
Here in the gallery, you are required to serve the Undead One. It is a great honor for you to be among all the trusted servants of the Priest King. Or do anything to draw his gaze. Though it would be a great honor for you to be sacrificed on the altar of sacred scent, we would be losing a loyal servant. To provide privacy for those of our kind using the gallery. The enchantment that allows you to understand our language will be disabled while you are in the area.
And that's the sinkhole entrance next to the teleportation. Obelisk, so it's right on top of the arena. You can drop down onto these things here and usually get to these gallery parts by dropping down and climbing. But if you fail, you die. You can also drop some demon blood, so let's skin you.
Watch your flanks! Me and me mates are thick as thieves!
guess this was the entire gallery now. All those chests also looted. And you can naturally drop down from here and grab onto a surface to avoid dying. It's a bit uneven, but so far I've never actually died getting down from this place. So let's not make this a first. Did I loot that chest earlier? Probably did. No, did not. And then we just run away. The snake's down there, and it's a world boss with a chest, so. Not really useful to kill it because we are not at level 60. Yeah, we did. Did get the quest item there. Just was too focused on the dragon horns to notice that we did get it. Just assumed that we did. So I guess we are mostly finished in the southern area of the world now. At least when it comes to the main plot. Still a good location for Brimstone crystal and puffball mushrooms. I don't think grow in the north, so if we want to have a bunch of poison arrows going forward, then we do need to gather some from these areas around the river. Well, there's actually that shrine to Hanuman that you yet to go to. We have 3 Nurtheimer hearts that we could sacrifice there. I'm not sure what Hanuman is in the Conan lore, but it seems to be some sort of apish god. When you sacrifice the hearts to him, there's a chance that you'll gain a gorilla-like pet, depending on what the heart is. And I think you can accidentally sacrifice even the heart of the sands to that altar, because it's a heart, so to speak. So you might actually accidentally do an oopsie and have to assemble it anew. So let's look at the Dragon Pound deck. All of them are their own entry. The bow's health damage 22. Our current ancient bow is 15. The one-handed axe is 54 health damage. Two-handed sword 63. Throwing axe 40. One-handed sword 51. Spear 51. Shield 44. Maul is 57. Javelin 57. Daggers 44. So the daggers has one higher damage than the base Misha's Bite has. And I think the bow's almost best in the game. But we can't really craft it because we don't have the sturdy string. And to get the sturdy string we need to have that rope maker, which is level 60 technology, which unlocks all the epic bows. So the dragonbone bow is listed as 22, the epic Bosonian bow is 21, so it's better than the DLC bows. Except maybe the flawless DLC bows are better. I don't remember if the well, in bows, flawless and exceptional are both plus one damage, I think. So the only difference might be durability and how to repair it. And as for is it in health maker? No, this one seems to be the one-handed weapons. The Lemurian sword is 47, the Dragonborn sword is 51, so it's seems to be better. But yeah, good margin. The Acheronian longsword is way worse, and it's also a level 60 tech. But the main use of one-handed weapons is that you'll have the offhand free for the shield or torch or reins, so you can fight horseback. As for the two-handed weapons, the maul, like mentioned earlier, has 57 damage, whereas these epic hammers are 52. And because the dragon bones weapons were added to the game at a point in time where their great access didn't exist, there's no dragon bone two-handed axe available. But these epic two-handed axes seem to have 69 base damage. Too bad their animations are basically horrible and really not worth using. The Acheronian two-handed sword is 53 in comparison to this 63, so huge difference there. But the Dragonbone two-handed sword is not the best two-handed sword in the game by far. You can actually get a better one crafted yourself. And it's probably what we're going to do when we get to that point in time. But the Maul is very decent. I think only some legendary mauls might be better because they usually come with some sort of added bonus. I think you can make these throwing axes and javelins. However, without that shaft thingy, so you can at least spend these if you really want to. Also, I'm not sure if the thrown weapons benefit from accuracy or strength. I'm guessing accuracy because they're a ranged weapon, but you never know. Some role-playing systems make them benefit from, like, your own hand strength instead of your hand and eye coordination. And the alchemical bases should be ready. So I guess we make steel fire then. And we only have limited amount of tar. So we won't be able to make the dismantling bench here and now. But we can make the insulated wood for it at least. So we're only low on the steel bars, maybe. And also on the bricks. Let's remove this corruption of ours by going to next to the dancer. Reminds me, I could also be crafting the map room at the same time. That would have been an optimal use of our time, but tunnel vision. Let's leave you here for now, because you're quest relevant. We don't want to accidentally lose you. We were to die and our body were to disappear again. Yeah, we're going to need a few units of stone to get the base going in the north. Fortunately, we do have a good tool now for it. Yeah, I think that's a better weight distribution option. We probably also want some iron, let's be honest. We need to build a blacksmith bench there, we're going to need iron for it. I need to take your stakes away too, just to store some additional weight on you. So we also need some wood. Actually weighing me down by that much. Possibly the arrows. And naturally the Wheel of Pain. And I'm not using my encumbrance armor set. I could use it, but when we teleport there, we're in the cold region, and this is heat-resistant armor, not cold-resistant, so we might be taking a lot of unnecessary damage, but I guess we can just tint one part of ogre gear to get the 30th level perk unlocked. And that's going to help a lot when it comes to our carry weight. I think I also need 50 bricks for the blacksmith bench. I think I'm carrying 10, so only 40 is needed. There's the Icor is now ready here. Basically these things. Let's actually check what the cooked fish offers when eaten. I think we can give them to you. Accuracy. apparently accuracy.